I need some audio to actually tell if it's working. For some reason it's working now. So just that I am both tired and I don't know, without fail I've been waking up completely tired. And yeah, I do have a slight headache. So yeah. I don't know if this might be my first time not going to D&D.
Remembering old times, Achilles?
Connor. Oh, yes, I suppose I was. Seems like so long ago.
Who was the assassin this belonged to?
Originally, it was John de la Tour's, the first assassin in the colonies. Then it was mine for a time. Ah, the things I've done wearing that armor. Some are uplifting to recall, others very painful indeed. One day, I will hand it over to you, Connor. It is your duty to keep it. It serves as a reminder for how long our Brotherhood has really been here, how long we've been protecting the people of this land. But here I am going on again. I know you appreciate what it is.
You want to tell him, my love?
I'm pregnant.
Congratulations.
It's been a long time coming. It does present a slight problem, however. There's no doctor for miles.
Well, then we should find one.
I know of one that may consider moving here. His name is Dr. Lyle White. It's been a turn since we last saw him, but you might try his old house in Boston.
Dr. White?
No. He's the drunken sotter on the corner. If you can get his attention, tell him I quit. All this ire on him. Not worth getting caught up in it. I have a family.
The Boston Weekly Advertiser.
You believe everything you read in the broadsheet.
Dr. White.
Yes?
My name is Connor.
And what can I help you with? Another quote for the broadsheets for you to twist against me?
I'm here to make you an offer.
Don't you know who I am? I'm the doctor the British have been slandering all over town. White Death. No?
I was given your name by my friends Warren and Prudence. Prudence is with child and requires a doctor's hand.
Prudence is pregnant? Ha! They've been trying for years, it seems. Maybe getting away from Boston is exactly what I need.
seem to just keep popping up.
What is it, Prudence?
I feel silly bothering you with this, but Warren's taken a yield to market in Boston. Could you round up the livestock for me? I've tried, but this baby in my belly takes the wind out of me.
Of course. I will see to it. Hip! Hip! This way! Not there. Faster.
Thank you, Connor. I could never have managed that.
It was my pleasure. Are you well?
I am. And I couldn't be happier. Warren and I have been waiting a long time for this. And if truth be told, we could not dream of a better place to raise our family.
Dr. White called upon us earlier. A very unexpected surprise. One that has put both Prudence and I at ease.
The village is growing, and a healer's services will benefit all.
Indeed. It's hard to explain how I am feeling right now. My wife is resting healthy and safe, full with child in our warm home. The community is kind and attentive, and the land is rich. It was not long ago that such a life was only a dream for us, Connor.
All people deserve to feel safe and free.
Hopefully a day will come when all men of the colony should share your perspective. But it will be a long, hard road. That much is certain.
it's a quick game of balls.
I see you are getting along again.
Oh, aye. We're always at each other for one thing or another, but more often than not, we work it out in the end. It's just the thought of my family threatened got me hot under the collar.
And? Terry knows he couldn't beat me in a fight.
You rat!
That's why he built this bowls pitch, so he could beat me at something. Still can't, though, can you, Terry?
I was winning till Connor came along!
Sure you were.
What am I supposed to be doing? Oh, are we just supposed to get near it? Okay, I actually know what I'm supposed to be doing now.
Puts the pressure on. That should do. Lady Luck is with me today.
shut since I started playing.
Puts the pressure on. Thank you. I hope we play again soon.
Okay, that's an interesting game. I don't understand it because I didn't get tutorial, but okay. That was indeed a game.
Yeah.
I don't know, I think it's gonna depend on if I actually go or not. It's gonna depend on what we're actually doing. Because there's pretty much, as long as it's not one of them, I don't really care, but I'd definitely find a way to survive the session.
Not the right gift. Bad news. She did not like the flowers. She tossed them aside.
But Prudence was certain.
I knew Miriam was not the type for flowers.
I will uncover this mystery myself, Norris.
All right, but please don't let her see you. She will think I'm bizarre.
Thank you.
she might appreciate a new knife. That blade has seen its prime.
Can I help you, Connor? Is this something to do with Norris?
Norris, I looked around her camp, and it seems she needs a new hunting knife. The one she is using has seen better days.
Ah, oui. That seems more right for her. I'll think on it. Merci.
The only thing I can think of is one, we could continue exploring the main map. Two, we could, I think we have a couple missions here. We have that mission, and then. Then I guess we might do the rescue to see what that is.
Thank you.
side objective. That was an easy mission. Definitely just firing down the entire line of them. Why does one of those have a red icon? Fire. was a easy mission as well. Doesn't change the fact I'm tired. Let's do this one, I guess, because it's gold.
Ahoy, Bobby!
Do you trust her?
With my life, Captain.
Hello. Name's Amanda. You must be the captain.
Now, what's all this about, then?
You stride into my bar off the piss and looking for officers. Days later, I start hearing whispers the ghost of the North Seas stalks the Atlantic again. The Aquila has returned, and I need her help. Nicholas Biddle now sails for the Patriots, captaining the Randolph. But the man is raiding up and down the coast round Nantucket, claiming it's a loyalist post.
Where is he now?
Speak of the devil.
Head below deck, Mandy. It's safer there.
I want to see this myself.
Randolph is attacking a merchant vessel not far from here.
Your orders.
We need to find out what Biddle intends, but we must hurry. What else do you know of Biddle?
All of a sudden, Congress has a brand new ship for him to captain. From British coxswain to captain of a colonial flagship, something doesn't add up. Heavy gust, Captain! Hard counter! That wind will push us hard up those rocks! Veer off! There's a storm coming, Captain. Feels like a big one. Well done, sir. That could have been ugly. Another captain. She's all yours. The Randolph has turned sail. Do we chase him?
We cannot leave this merchant vessel to the mercy of the English.
Why is Biddle doing this? Nantucket is for the Patriots!
The company he keeps tells me his true allegiance lies elsewhere.
A salute to us, sir. They're safe. What now?
Pursue the Randolph.
Who are they? More English by the cut of their jibs.
Where's the Randolph?
He's gone, sir. Cut and run. Left us to deal with this rabble. But this storm concerns me a great deal more.
We have little choice.
Aye. Time your shots between the waves, sir. Then we must find shelter, or it won't be cannon fire that ends up. I'd say it's high time we find some cover from this storm, Captain!
I agree, Mr. Faulkner. We make for the vineyard! I have never seen weather like that.
It's rare, but it happens. You did well. What's bothering me is Biddle's a patriot now. Why is he helping the British Navy like that? Old friends, maybe?
Well, how would you convince the Continental Congress the Navy needs more ships?
The rash of British raiding the coast is reason enough to address the gripe. Gunboats at the vineyard, now this.
Biddle aims to be the first admiral of the Colonial Navy and is making a case for the need.
That was some deft sailing, Captain. I was watching from the gun deck.
What were you doing on the gun deck? I told you to stay out of harm's way.
I'm fine, Bobby, not to worry. The people of Nantucket are surely grateful, and so am I. Glad you're back!
Thank you.
with that, I'm gonna call it. I'm gonna take a short break and then go do Ni No Kuni. Okay, either way, that's going to be all for right now.